Welcome everybody to my final video for my 8-part review on the hunt for the Decepticons, Constructicons. Yeah, as you can see, I have all the Constructicons in their vehicle modes, simply because the Constructicons always form Devastator in their vehicle modes. Yeah. Here I got got all seven. I got Overload, Rampage, Long Haul, Scrapper, Hightower, Scavenger, and Mixmaster. All ready to combine. So without further ado, let's get started. First of all, let's start with the legs. Let's start with Long Haul here. Pretty much same as he turned to his robot mode. You bend the body like that, and bend like that. And then, flip. There's piece up. Then bend his legs forward like that, and now he got a leg for Devastator. A Rampage here. I'm gonna split the shovel like this. Pull down the treads. Just keep pulling them till they collapse. Then you want to pull down the. No, sorry, wrong side. Flip it like this. Try to collapse his legs. That. Then you got. Reconnect the shovel before, and then you got another leg for Devastator. Now we have Overload. Pretty much same as you want to bend these two halves in half. Want to flip. First flip this hook up. Bend his truck head in half. Split the truck cab and split it like this. And bend his back part of the truck. Then you got a lower body of Devastator, and you want to plug. Use this tab right here. Plug in these holes right here. See, snap in that place. Come on there. There you go. Next we take Scavenger. Pretty much, what you want to do with him is pretty much changing him back to his robot mode. Want to fold these out. Flip these treads. So you want to. Split the shovel. Turn these aside. Now fold these treads and something like this. Fold these arms together. Now next is a very tricky part. Yeah, see these rails right here. Yeah, see these rails. See these little slots right here. They are gonna slide into these tabs on overload. So you want to line it out properly and it's slides into place. And there you have. And next you want to take the hook, take this hook thing and attach the wheels to create a solid back for Devastator. Yeah, it's getting big. Next, the arms. We take scrapper here. You want to. It's very simple. You want to split the shovel, turn these. It becomes the fingers of Devastator. Then you want to put. Then you use this connector hole, which goes into this peg on Scavenger's shoulder, Scavenger's elbows. And just like that. Next, you're gonna take Hightower, fold this hook, uncup this so you can extend the crane arm better and clip it in. Then you want to do is just create the fingers. Now he got his arm. Now he got the arm of Devastator, which here's a connector. Here's a peg hole, and here's a peg. You know, do is try to tab it, just like that. And last piece, you got mix. Last, you got Mixmaster. What you want to do with him? Want to flip open the truck bed? Flip up this, and now you got the head of Devastator, and you want to fold these legs so it can fit around Scavenger's wheels. So what you want to do this? There's two. There's two. See, there's two tabs on top of on Scavenger's head, which are for the slot holes on Mixmaster. So you want to plug that in, just like that. Fold these legs, and there you have it. You got the Devastator, all complete. It is robot mode. Legend class Devastator is all complete. Very, very awesome. One cool thing about this repaint is that all the green of all the figures makes Devastator looks like one solid figure. Even though he's made of seven different parts. Something. Yeah, that's what makes this set even better looking than the Constructicons that came or Revenge of the Fallen had their movie accurate colors. So yeah. Yeah, he's got the nice red eyes, typical for a Decepticon. And his arm. Sorry, I guess his white kind of makes like a never it makes a look. So yeah, what's cool about and this Devastator or G1 Nod, this Devastator has the bucket the back end of the dump truck for his back. Just like in G1. So yeah, and I give you an idea how big he is here compared to another. So yeah, he's pretty big. However, not big enough as, he's basically the size of a typical deluxe figure. But scale aside, this is by far the best Devastator ever released for the movie. In fact, probably the best combiner that we got since G1. So. Yeah, and my final thoughts for Revenge of the Fallen, Hunt for the Decepticons Devastator, is if you have the original Constructicons already, then you don't bother getting this guy because it's just waste your money. Yeah, only difference in between this version and the original Fallen version is the color. But if you don't have it, then I strongly suggest to pick this one up as a good or even better alternative. Yeah, especially for diehard G1 fans like me. Yeah, and this version is even better than the Supreme Devastator. Is that you get what you want? I mean, 7 vehicles. Each of them have their own individual robot mode, and they all combine for one giant robot. That's the way they did it in the movie. That's the way the G1 Constructicons were, and this figure captured that perfectly. So yeah, it's kind of ironic that this toy can outpass a super expensive Supreme Devastator. Yeah. So yeah, if you're a fan of combiners like me, please pick up Devastator. Yeah, he's very cool and very cheap. I already got him completed at Toys R Us for only $30 for him. So yeah, there's a cheaper alternative to the G1. You can't afford G1 Constructicons. And that's pretty much it for my review for my review on the Constructicons. If you like this video, please subscribe to my videos. And help you enjoy my dog's background singing too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.